engineering is something I've always wanted to do. I originally started off looking towards computer engineering, but then eventually transitioned to aerospace. What drew me to aerospace is the fact that we're not limited to just mechanical engineering or just electrical engineering. We handle everything that has to do with airplanes. I'm Robert Rivera, and I'm the lead operations engineer on Global Hawk. NASA's Global Hawks are set up primarily for doing airborne research. All the sensors that are normally on the airplane for the military mission have been removed, so we fly just the payloads that are required to do the mission.
Fort NASA 872. I need to set up a left-hand orbit here for a few minutes just to collect some data.
One advantage of doing this air-based research that we do is we can get to parts of the world where we can't put up ground-based systems. A lot of our research happens out over the Atlantic or over the Pacific, looking at the atmosphere, looking at the different types of chemicals up in the tropopause, what kind of pollutants we're seeing. We can spend 14 hours in a storm and watch it transition from a tropical storm to a hurricane. It also allows us to go fly satellite tracks and be able to calibrate the weather satellites that are flying overhead so we can verify that they're giving us correct amount of information so that we can better improve the models of how we forecast the weather of the world. There are conflicting requirements on this campaign. We're just going to have to let the forecasters duke it out and work out what the... An operations engineer is essentially the aircraft manager here. We're responsible for the configuration of the airplane, the airworthiness of the aircraft, and making sure that all the maintenance is accomplished in a reasonable manner within the schedule that's given to us. We're not specialized into a particular discipline. We're allowed to basically cross disciplines and work where we need to do the job.
Come down and out of the way with this.
What I've been doing on the Global Hawk is integrating payloads onto the airplane. I'm basically given a payload, here's the mounting points, here's where we're putting it on the airplane, and then I have to figure out how to put it on the airplane, then cut the work orders to have the shops build the parts, and then get them technicians to install the parts on the airplane. We have two primary payloads that we put on this airplane. The first type is an in-situ instrument. The second type are called remote sensing instruments. The CAS program we're currently involved in is two instruments. One is a cloud particle measurement instrument. It actually takes in cloud particles and through lasers looks at the shape of the particles in the clouds. The other one is a remote sensing instrument. It actually looks at the sun glint off of the water and breaks down what's in the air column that it's looking through, what kind of chemicals are there, the methane levels, the carbon dioxide levels. My part of the Ghost design was taking the Northrop Engineering installation and adding in the cooling and ventilation system for the instrument. What you'll see here on my design is that the air comes into the airplane, goes through their computer for cooling, and then through a manifold, which the LN2 vents out, the liquid nitrogen vents out, which is what they use to cool the instrument. A lot of our science teams that we get in here are not aircraft people. They build the laboratory standards, not aircraft standards. One of the biggest challenges is solving that difference between what they bring us and what we can put on the airplane and how to safely put something that's built to one standard on the airplane and meet the standards we have.
It's in the hole there.
Okay.
Now, who's in?
This one isn't yet.
Yeah.
Okay. Mark where the foot's going to go. That's where your ATR is going to go. I know you guys are anxious to see this all up there and flying.
Yeah, it's the end of the long design process for us.
We're basically using up every nook and cranny of the airplane we can find. Getting these instruments, figuring out where to put them and making them all fit. Very much like Tetris.
Larry, you want to pull the pad on your way?
Yeah, quarter turn on the back. Let's tighten the outboard front again. Essentially what we're doing is we're putting preload into the 8th instrument pod. For flight, what it does is it improves the stiffness of the pod while we're flying so it doesn't move around too much.
roll call real quick. Two pilots are here.
Typically on a flight day, I act as one of the mission directors for the flight.
Mission director, I assume that's going to be you?
Myself and Chris will be in training.
Our job as mission directors is working with the scientists and with the pilots. So when the scientists have changing requirements, we're the one who gets them first. And then we'll work with them to make sure they're what the pilots can do. And then we pass them on to the pilots. And we negotiate with the pilots to get what we can for the scientists.
Sounds like we're good to go.
Doors up, power's up, vehicle's moving.
That's 872, roger, hold short, runway 22 right.
Payload mission, we're on the runway and setting up for takeoff.
Roger, we're still go for takeoff. Okay, here we go.
Vehicles airborne.
This is a few copies.
Have a good flight.
We're also basically responsible for assisting the pilots in any emergencies that happen on the airplane, any flight planning that needs to be done. We do have real-time downlinks, so the scientists are always looking at the data. We change our mission plan based off the data they're seeing come down real-time.
We're 15,000. And for the cards, we're on M2, step Mike 6. And I'm showing DC-13 and IL-13 off.
We're also the ones that have controls of the payload system for turning on instruments and turning off instruments up in the front room.
DC-12 on, please.
DC-12 on.
Once we finish one campaign, we're prepping for the next campaign or cleaning up, doing maintenance on the airplane. So we're pretty much constantly busy from one to the next. Basically, the favorite part of my job is the whole process, seeing a project or an integration effort from beginning to end. Basically, being able to take something that may never have been designed to go on an airplane and then seeing it flying in a reasonable amount of time. What I like about NASA is that they're doing things that you would not necessarily see done in private industry because there's really no cost benefit to them. There's a scientific and a longevity benefit to them. NASA can do the airborne research and improve our models to better predict weather so we can get people out of the way when storms come through. We can better predict how strong a hurricane's gonna get so we can make sure the proper personnel are in place for response to that hurricane. We gather so much data, it takes years to process all the data, but all that will eventually end up in the public domain. I would tell kids that are interested in engineers is learn your math, learn your science, be interested, take things apart, put things together, work with your hands, just get the experience of building and figuring out how things work.